Good morning, students. Today we will study about the decline of Indian textile industry. As the cotton industry developed in England, Indian cotton weavers faced many problems. First of all, Indian textile now had to compete with British textiles in the European and American markets. Secondly, exporting textiles to England became increasingly difficult, as very high duties were imposed on Indian textiles imported into Britain. In the beginning of the 19th century, English-made cotton textiles were preferred to Indian goods because they were very cheap and in good quality. Indian textiles lost their market in Africa, America, and Europe. And if you see, the three main reasons for the decline of textile industry in India are as follows. After the Industrial Revolution, Britain started producing machine-made textiles, which were often of better quality and cheaper than Indian textiles. Now the textile or the cloth manufactured with the help of machines, it used to be very good in quality and it could be produced at a very low rate, because if you produce something in bulk, then what happens? The production cost gets reduced. Now the machines were able to do the work of four or five people at a time. So what these people were paid, now only one man could do the work done by five people. So obviously there was a cut in the production cost, and thus the goods became cheap. Matlab jab panch logon ka kaam ek insaan hi kar sakta hai, to obviously jo un panch logon ko paise diye ja rahe hain, to wo ek aadmi ko diya ja raha hai, to char logon ka paisa bach gaya, to kya ho gaya, samaan aapka sasta ho jata hai. Textiles from India had high demands in Europe. So British passed strict laws and banned the import of textiles in Britain, as we had seen the Calico Act over there, which they had passed in Britain to not allow Indian calico to be sold in British market. Also, India had no support from the colonial British government. These British people, they did not support the Indian weavers and gave them no protection. Export of British goods to India increased, and the Manchester goods flooded Indian market. The machine made goods were cheaper and weavers could not compete with them. And in fact, the raw cotton export from India for the newly emerging British textile industry increased, and that shot up the prices of cotton in the Indian market. So now our Indian weavers had to buy raw cotton at very high price, because all that was produced, the raw cotton that was produced in India, was sent to Britain for the newly emerging industries in Britain. Mechanized production of cotton textiles made Britain the foremost industrial nation in the 19th century. The steady growth of the iron and steel industry in British gave it the distinction of being the workshop of the world. British industrialists began to see India as a vast market for their industrial products. Soon, goods manufactured in Britain began to flood India. The influx of British goods on Indian soil had a tremendous impact on Indian crafts and industries. Now what was happening? The newly emerging British industries, they needed a market for their industrial products. So what they did was, now they started to sell their products in their colonies, and India was a very big market for these goods produced in the British industries. Now, what happened after the Industrial Revolution to the Indian textile industry was that the thousands of weavers in India were thrown out of employment because the weaving industry or the handloom weaving had given livelihood to millions of Indians, be it men or women. Now what happened, thousands of weavers in India were thrown out of employment. अब उनके पास काम नहीं था क्योंकि जितना भी स्पिनिंग वीविंग सारा कुछ है ये ब्रिटेन में होना शुरू हो गया और वो भी मशीनों के द्वारा। तो 10 लोगों का काम मशीन अकेले कर लेता था, तो ये 10 लोग क्या हो जाते थे, अनएम्प्लॉयड हो गए, उनके पास काम नहीं है। और जो ये लोग जेनरेशन से जो काम कर रहे हैं इनको अब कोई भी काम नहीं मिल रहा है करने के लिए, तो क्या हो गया, ये सब अनएम्प्लॉयड हो गए। इंग्लिश एंड यूरोपियन कंपनीज स्टॉप्ड बाइंग इंडियन गुड्स एंड देयर एजेंट्स नो लॉन्गर गेव एडवांस टू वीवर्स टू सिक्योर सप्लाई। अर्लियर फॉर प्रोक्योरिंग इंडियन टेक्सटाइल्स दीज एजेंट्स ऑफ द यूरोपियन कंपनीज दे यूज टू गिव आवर वीवर्स ह्यूज एडवांस एंड बुक देयर सप्लाईज। नाउ दे डिड नॉट नीड द products of our Indian weavers because that had become costly. The work done by Indian weavers was by hand and so it used to be a bit costlier than the goods produced in Britain by machines. So British machine made cotton cloth flooded Indian market by 1830s. By 1880, two-thirds of all the cotton cloth worn by Indians were made of cloth produced in Britain. This affected not only specialized weavers but also spinners. Thousands of women who made a living by spinning cotton thread lost their job. And then these workers, the weavers, they wrote petitions to the government to help them, and we can see one such petition here by a group of weavers. There comes a word, owing to our misfortune, the Orabs have been abolished ever since, because of which we and our families are distressed for want of the means of livelihood. Here, Aurang means it's a Persian term for a warehouse, a place where goods are collected before being sold. It also refers to a workshop. So, it's a Persian term for a warehouse. Now, what happened to the weavers and spinners who lost their livelihood? So, since they had no work, now what was happening was the Indian market was flooded with all the textiles being brought from Britain and sold at a very low price. So Indian market was flooded with the British products, and thus the weavers and spinners, they lost their livelihood. मतलब उनका अब रोजगार नहीं रहा। Many weavers became agricultural laborers. तो अब ये क्या करने लगे? So many of them, since they had no work, they became agricultural laborers. मतलब ये खेतों में काम करने लगे। Some migrated to cities in search of work. कुछ ऐसे ही normal labor की तरह शहरों की तरफ चले गए काम के लिए। Some handloom weavers found work in the new cotton mills that were established in Bombay, Ahmedabad, Solapur, Nagpur and Kanpur. Others went out of the country to work in plantations in Africa and South America. तो कुछ भी करके ये लोग अपना रोजगार चलाने लगे। But handloom weaving did not completely die in India. This was because some types of cloths could not be supplied by machines like saris with intricate borders or cloth with traditional woven patterns, which had a wide demand not only amongst the rich but also amongst the middle classes. So some of the things could not be made by machines, So those type of weavers were still surviving. And then the coarse cloth used by the poor people in India was also not manufactured in Britain. So two qualities of cloth were still being manufactured by the Indian weavers. One was the ones with beautiful traditional designs and intricate borders. And then other quality was the coarse cloth. Coarse मतलब बहुत मोटा रफ कपड़ा जो गरीब इंसान पहनते थे, तो इनको भी इंडियन वीवर्स बना रहे थे. देन कॉटन मिल्स इन इंडिया. द फर्स्ट कॉटन मिल वॉज सेट अप इन इंडिया एज अ स्पिनिंग मिल इन बॉम्बे इन 1854. बाई 1900 ओवर 84 मिल्स स्टार्टेड ऑपरेटिंग इन बॉम्बे. मिल्स केम अप इन अदर सिटीज टू लाइक अहमदाबाद, कानपुर, यूनाइटेड प्रोविंसेस, शोलापुर एंड नागपुर. सो द मिल विच केम अप इन अहमदाबाद वॉज इन 1861, देन इन 1862 इन कानपुर एंड यूनाइटेड प्रोविंसेस. सो स्लोली एंड स्लोली दीज कॉटन मिल्स स्टार्टेड कमिंग अप इन इंडिया ऑल्सो. एंड मेनी ऑफ दीज वर एस्टैब्लिश्ड बाई पारसी एंड गुजराती बिजनेसमैन हु हैड मेड देयर मनी थ्रू ट्रेड विथ चाइना. सो अगेन यू कैन सी द चाइनीज वेर अ बिट हेल्पफुल टू इंडियन वीवर्स ऑल्सो. ग्रोथ ऑफ कॉटन मिल्स लेड टू अ डिमांड फॉर लेबर. थाउजेंड्स ऑफ पुअर पेसेंट्स, आर्टिजन्स, बट एग्रीकल्चरल लेबरर्स, दे ऑल मूव टू द सिटीज टू वर्क इन दीज कॉटन मिल्स. We can see the picture of the first Indian cotton mill, which was opened in 1854 in Bombay. Now it's known as Mumbai. Earlier it was known as Bombay. You can see people working on the machines. Now they're not working with their hands. These are all machines. You can see women also working in the cotton factory. But the textile factory industry in India faced many problems. It found it difficult to compete with the cheap textiles imported from Britain. In most countries, the government supported industrialization by imposing heavy duties on imports. This eliminated competition and protected infant industries or the very new coming industry. But the colonial government in India, it refused protection to local industries or the new industries. And thus, the Indian textile industries were not able to compete with the British cloth industry. It was also difficult for Indian textile to compete with the cheap textiles imported from Britain. So, all this was happening, and the government was not at all willing to help. But the first major spurt in the development of cotton factory production in India was during the First World War, when textile imports from Britain declined and Indian factories were called upon to produce cloth for the military supplies. But somehow or the other, the Indian textile industry got a chance to thrive during the First World War. So we come to the end of today's topic. There are some questions given here. I would like all of you to read the chapter thoroughly. You will find all the answers in your book and answer these questions in your copy. Define Aurang. What happened to the weavers and spinners who lost their livelihood? When did the first major spurt in the development of cotton factory production come in India? And name the places where new cotton mills were established. So my request is, please read the chapter thoroughly, and I have given you questions in the past two videos. So three videos with three sets of questions. Please try to complete the question answers which are being asked in the video or which I am going to send at the end of the chapter. Please complete everything in your copy. Do not leave pending work. And try to learn the answers as well. Okay, thank you, children.